All right, Barack Obama is here. Had a lot of time to think about people, you know, when the Washington was attacked, when the New York City was attacked. And for us in the Northeast, it was, I think, more about Rudy Giuliani. He was our savior here in this city than it was about George Bush and the national strategy. But now, this is stuff you got to think about. Absolutely. You have to think about it. What would you have done then? What kind of a situation would we be in now if you had been the president then?
Well, first of all, I think Giuliani deserves credit. He kept calm and he was clear. I still remember your show after it happened and how moving that was. That was one of the most powerful moments on television. I think that George Bush did the right thing by going after the Taliban in Afghanistan. And I would have done the exact same thing. And the big difference between myself and George Bush, I think, would have been to stay focused on Afghanistan, not get distracted by Iraq. I think we would have tamped down al-Qaeda. We could have, if not captured or killed bin Laden, at least made sure that they weren't setting up the kind of base camps that have now reconstituted themselves. So they've got safe haven in the mountains between Pakistan and Afghanistan. And I think in terms of the United States, there was just this outpouring. You remember. People wanted to do something.
Sure.
And you know, George Bush asked him to shop. And if we had instead said, you know what, we are going to reduce our dependence on Middle Eastern oil, or you know, we are going to create the kinds of energy-efficient economy that will allow us to weaken the forces of terror, that could have made an incredible difference. And I think you could have mobilized the American people around bold plans on energy that would make sure that we weren't continuing to be in the situation we're in today.
Now, two things. It's been called to my attention, and you see it on television. There's documentaries about it, and the book's been published about it, that seconds after the first plane hit the tower, there was chaos in Washington, D.C. Is that your understanding, that systems that everybody took for granted about being in place were not in place, and if they were, nobody knew how to run them?
Well, there's no doubt it was a shock to the system. And, you know, the failures of intelligence have been well documented. I think some of the systems broke down. But, you know, my interest is not in playing Monday morning quarterback. I think that any president who was there would have had to deal with a whole range of problems that we hadn't anticipated before. What I am concerned about is that we have not taken the steps since that time that would make us safer. Mm-hmm. I think that if we had stayed focused in Afghanistan, if we had, instead of spending $1 trillion in Iraq, had focused on our energy problems here at home, if we had started hardening our chemical plants and our ports in ways that we still haven't done and implemented the 9/11 Commission reports, then we couldn't guarantee that 9/11's not repeated, but we would be further along in making sure that America was safe. And the other thing we would have done is we would have maintained the sympathy of the world and the alliances that have been frayed so badly over the last several
years. More or less decimated.
Absolutely.
Now, you mentioned twice staying focused in Afghanistan, and we have seen relatively so. We had a short visit in Afghanistan militarily, and now there's trouble there in Afghanistan. What would maintaining focus there mean? What does that
mean? Well, it means a couple
things. Would
it
mean the similar situation as we have in Iraq? Would it mean an American and military control of the country?
Well, I do think we've got to have more troops there, so I think we've got to have a couple of more brigades. But just as important is the non-civilian side. What are we doing in terms of giving farmers there an alternative to growing poppy?
Right?
So narco-trafficking has funded terrorism in that region.
Right.
What are we doing in terms of rooting out corruption in the Afghan government so people actually trust what's going on there?
Also schools, medical care.
And what are we doing in terms of dealing with Pakistan?
Mm-hmm.
Because the fact is that bin Laden and al-Qaeda, they are on the Pakistani side of the border. We were funding this guy Musharraf, providing him $10 billion in military assistance, and they were not going after these folks that are sitting there hatching plots to attack the United States again. And you know, one of the things that we've got to recognize is that if we are protecting dictators because we think that's the best we can do. We're actually creating an environment in Pakistan that becomes anti-American and feeds the kinds of militancy that can end up damaging us badly.
This sort of discussion, because I don't have the brain power for it, makes my head hurt.
Does it hurt?
Actually makes my head hurt. I want you to tell us a little bit about, I think when you were 10 or 11 years old, was your first trip to the mainland.
Is that right? I was living in Hawaii.
And you came with your sister?
I came with my 2-year-old sister, my mom, and my grandma. Mm-hmm. And we went to Seattle because that's where my family had lived before they moved to Hawaii.
And they decided it was time, as nice as Hawaii is, time to see more of the country.
So we went to Seattle. We went to Disneyland, which was big. Mm-hmm. They got a lot of points for that.
As a kid, you responded the way kids respond to that?
Yeah, Dave, I mean, you know, kids in Hawaii, they know about Mickey Mouse and things like that.
Checking.
Yeah. Yeah, it's Disneyland, man. I mean, they, you know, kids like that.
I don't know what it's like in Hawaii. I don't know what's going on over there.
So, what do you think? We went and kind of looked around and said, what the heck is this?
Yes. Yes, I do.
So we went to Disneyland. We went to the Grand Canyon, went to Yosemite. Grand Canyon was great. My first trip to Chicago was on that trip, mm-hmm. and went to the Field Museum. And I still remember this. They had shrunken heads, real shrunken heads, which, you know, when you're... 10-year-old boys are kind of strange because 11-year-old boys, that was fascinating to me. Yeah. I mean, that was actually the highlight. That was almost as good as Disneyland.
Was right up everybody's alley. Shrunken heads, that's right.
Yeah. I thought that was pretty cool.
And did it create any kind of yearning? Did it create any kind of an awareness that, not the shrunken heads, but the whole trip?
You know what it did, and this is actually something that happens. People ask me, well, what have you learned as you've been campaigning for 19 months? And, you know, you realize what a spectacular country this is,
right.
and how big it is, and how beautiful it is, and it really underscored for me just how lucky we are to be Americans.
Yeah. All right, good enough. We'll be right back with Senator Barack Obama, ladies and gentlemen.